Lloyd's Register on ships and in shipyards everywhere, supporting safety and sustainability in your industry.
A fatal incident in Tradewind's casualty roundup this week was not on a ship, but in the air. Three seafarers are believed to have been among the doomed passengers aboard Air France Flight 447 when it disappeared above the Atlantic. A Croatian and a Filipino crewman were on the plane, as was the Scottish master of a Subsea 7 vessel. Also on board was an executive with Brazil's Atlântico Sul shipyard. Pirates continued to suffer setbacks off Somalia as navies held off attacks. A Spanish naval aircraft and a British warship coordinated to stop a suspected hijack attempt by men in these two boats, which were spotted near the general cargo ship JS Matu. British soldiers confiscated weapons and released the men, but not before making sure they had one less boat to use in future attacks. The week also saw pirates release the Nigerian tug Yenagoa Ocean, which had been held hostage for 10 months. There was one successful hijacking, but it was nowhere near Somalia. The tug Top Niche 5 was boarded by pirates in the fifth attack off South Malaysia this year. The raiders grabbed cash, personal belongings, portable radios, and binoculars before fleeing. In the islands of southern Chile, the tanker Estrecho de Magallanes suffered a propulsion failure, but the appearance of calmer seas allowed the ship to move to safer waters, as Navy and other tugs sped to the scene of the incident. An Indonesian ferry caught fire and sank off the island of Java, but a passing ship was able to rescue at least 350 people. Authorities did not immediately know how the fire started on the vehicle deck of the Mandiri Nusantara. Between 5 and 15 people were missing after the incident. A U.S. Coast Guard helicopter took two seafarers to a hospital after they were hurt in an explosion on an offshore supply vessel. The Captain Rain was operating off the Louisiana coast when the blast occurred. The cause of the incident was not immediately known. The crewmen suffered burns, but their injuries were not life-threatening. Russia saw a pair of incidents. Five crew members were injured when the Nevsky 17 suffered an engine room fire on Lake Onega. And in the Caspian Sea, the tanker Alexander ran aground but was able to refloat without any pollution. The tanker Great News smashed into a pier serving Jamaica's only refinery. Damage to the vessel appeared minimal, but the incident sent officials scrambling for a temporary way to unload tankers. The government insists that crude will continue to flow into the Petrojam refinery. And looking back, Australian investigators have blamed lookouts on both vessels in the 2008 collision between the container ship Northern Fortune and a fishing vessel. The crash destroyed the bow of the fishing boat Elena. The third mate of the box ship also took heat for failing to render assistance to the Elena and failing to inform his master of the crash. The officer believed that there had been no collision.